What's up, guys? Welcome to Malik's YouTube channel, you know, one source for trending news, celebrity gossip, and entertainment news. If you're joining us for the first time, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Malik's YouTube channel, innit? Let's see what the news have for us today. Marriage scandal, how FCMB managing director allegedly had two children with female staff members, innit? So yesterday, DNA was trending on Twitter. There was a whole discussion a lot about DNA, and it all started from this news. A managing director at FCMB, that's a Nigerian bank, had two children with his staff. And guess how all this happened? So apparently she was working at the bank. The guy was her oga, was the MD. They had two kids. Now she was married to another man. The guy didn't know. Then his wife told him she was going to travel to the US. She traveled to the US with the kids. On reaching the US, she called her husband and she's like, "Honey, what's up? I'm in the US with the kids. And just so you know, those two children are not yours." That made the man went into stroke. He now recovered. He found somebody else to marry. He went into cardiac arrest. He finally died. And yesterday, people were calling for him to get sacked. Is that the right call to make? So according to the whole news, that's why people are saying, get a DNA test. And that's why DNA was trending. But now people are petitioning that this guy should be sacked, man. People are saying they should sack him. Like, you can't still hold your job. And when you look at the picture of the MD, the wife, and the kids, you could actually tell without any DNA that, damn, this is not this guy's child. This is for the MD. And the guy's name is Nuru. I don't want to call his other name, but all these things are allegedly in it. All these things are allegedly. And where's the picture of the... they didn't put the picture of the kids. But that was the guy. The man's name is Moyo Thomas, and the guy's name was Thomas Tunde Thomas. May so rest in peace. He died 45 years old. He died from the pain, the heartbreak that his wife told him his two kids are not his. We led the question: will you want to have a DNA on your kids, and will you tell your wife about it? Nigerians went back and forth about it yesterday, and this lady went, "Man, if DNA confirms the baby is not yours, it doesn't change the fact you must take responsibility of the baby. Women go through a lot in marriages and deserve better." Guys, drop a comment in the comment section and tell me, will you actually father a child that DNA has confirmed that it's not yours? Will you still want to take care of that child? Will you want to bear responsibility for that child? And first of all, man, will you actually go and do a DNA test for your own kids? And if you will go and do that, will you tell your wife before you do that? This girl says, if men confirm the baby, this girl says, no matter what the result of the DNA says, you should take care of the child, which I don't agree with. And she went further to say, when a married man impregnates a woman or his wife will be told to forgive and endure. Every gender should be treated fairly. I mean, if there's something we're really missing here, is that we're trying to agree that Nigerian women cheat a lot. Because there was a whole statistic where they say gender maternity fraud. In Jamaica, it's like that 6%. In Nigeria, it's 30%. So in every three kids that are giving birth to in Nigeria, one is not for the father. I know. I was wondering how many guys are walking around and they're just being fathered by their uncle or somebody else. But that's a crazy thing. Like, who would have guessed that women have issues with being there? Like, it should be that, oh, you want to have a DNA test? Oh, cool, do that. But how do you think I was going to get pregnant? So the women are insinuating that if you're going to say you should have a DNA test, you're insinuating they cheated in it. And one guy just came out and said, "Guy, you there saying you don't want the DNA test, are you sure your father is your father?" And everywhere just busted. And this person, still on DNA issue, say, "I would divorce my husband if he asked for a DNA test after giving birth." Really? You would divorce him? Did you marry him? I mean, I get this issue where people are saying, "I would divorce my husband, I'll do this." But if he's asking for a DNA test, I believe there will be a reason for him to ask for a DNA test. And there's nothing there, it's just a DNA test. And for a reason, for the hell of me, why would you want to ask your wife for a DNA test? If you want to do any DNA test for your child, if you want to do a DNA test for your child, you take the swab of the mouth, you take his hair, and go and do a DNA test. And most times, man, most times women, most times that you hear about the DNA test is because it is false. That's the only reason why you hear about it. If it goes right, the guy will trash it and chop his L and move forward in it. Let's see what Miss Eniola / Carolina Herrera in training says. She's like, "God knows, if I use my body to carry your child and you ask for a DNA test, I'll give you that test and afterwards your divorce papers. My dear, what I found entertaining is how many men are rushing to say they'll conduct DNA tests without understanding what they're actually saying. So she's saying that if you say you're going to conduct DNA test, you're probably insinuating your wife cheated on you. And if you're insinuating that you're going to ask your wife, oh, I want to DNA test on this kid, you're trying to say she cheated on you, and she's trying to say if she's in that position, she's going to divorce you, because why will you assume she cheated on you? And guess what? Somebody came forward on Twitter and like, her boyfriend is beating her and she actually can't leave the boyfriend and she's saying she should divorce him. And that person said, why are you afraid of the DNA test when I've not even married you in it? So many things about DNA test, but that FCMB story was crazy. The guy was fathering two kids, and if you look at those kids, they look perfectly like that MD. So she was knocking her ogre at work, and the husband was not the father of the kids, was thinking of the kids. She left with the kids to the US. And when he got to the US, when she got to the US, was when she told him about everything, which was very, very heartless. But the guy died in the end. On a sadder note, Nigeria actually restricts these 100 passengers, their passport, they put their passport number online. And the whole gist is that these guys restricted the COVID-19 rules. Like when you come back into the country, you're supposed to be in isolation for at least a week or 2 weeks. But these guys, with all their passport numbers, they have been restricted from traveling for the next 6 months. So the next 6 months, they can't leave the country. They restricted the rules. Guys, drop a comment in the comment section and tell me, what do you think about this? Nigerian government rights, or these people are wrong for actually restricting the rules? Because, I mean, if we're allowing churches, markets and everything to go on, why are we now restricting some people? But at the same time, man, the cases of COVID are increasing. Like, it can be these 100 people that are increasing the cases in it. Because it got to a point in time where these COVID cases were going down. And all of a sudden, December came and they spiked. And then we're hearing that 100 passengers actually defaulted. There's something to be there. There's something to be looked at there. I wish these guys didn't default, because now we're going back to probably just a lockdown. So guys, tell me what you think about that in the comment section. Thanks for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos like this. Turn the post notification to get notified anytime we drop a new video. See you guys next time.